called to cremate.
Yes, and we have infectious, dead persons who die of infectious illness, part of the protocol is to dispose body or even or cremate the remains as soon as possible.
Thank you very much.
Secretary Duque, may request ko kung may sir, yung directive po na iba na yung flights, was it under your recommendation? And what and why the change po? The recommendation? Kasi parang previously, hindi pa yun.
Two days lang, di ba? Yung una.
Yes.
Last Friday, the task force met on the local coronavirus attended by the Department of Foreign Affairs, DOJ, Bureau of Immigration, the EIRG, the Department of Transportation, the Department of Tourism, the Department of well, the DNT and the DNT were also there. And so that was the recommendation to expand the travel ban to persons and travelers coming from anywhere from China and the special initiative of Asia. So that is now the basis for the China-wide ban. Temporary ban.
Sir, it's interagency or was it
the interagency? It is a resolution that was agreed upon by all the members of the task force. Anyway, the task force, the legal personality of the task force is on the EO 168 of 2014 and the OMSI task force.
Question?
Sir, sorry for asking. Sir, kayo po yung namuna po ba? To recommend the expansion of the...
As the chair, yes. But suffice it to say that it's the task force. I happen to be the chair for the board directive.
Sir, part of the question, ha? Kasi po parang previously, nabanggit nyo na para, baka this might affect po yung relations with China.
So, no, no more. The events have escalated. The WHO last Friday had declared a public health emergency of international concern. And so in the exercise of our sovereign rights, the president, bearing in mind the protection of our people, has approved the recommendation of the task force. And that is why the China-wide task
force.
Yes.
Sir, yung increase nung ano, parang sa tingin nyo ba mabilis? From 200 yun, ngayon 304. How can we handle, meron dating sapat na equipment para i-handle to? At yung bilang, yung pacing ng increase, sa tingin nyo, alarming na ba? O hindi pa alarming yung bilang ng increase ng mga namatay? Particular, although hindi naman sa atin sa China, sir, 304.
Well, yun po kasing dumadami cases sa China naman. Okay. Sa atin, actually, our persons under investigation have not been increasing rapidly. And I think with the ban now of the president, it will be a lot easier for us. Kasi kukontinan po yung mabantayan natin ang pag-asak.
Yung coordination niyo, sir, sa mga airport, kasi baka magkamali, that is important eh. Kasi ang pasukan sa airport, sa Palampantalan, papaano natin ma-address yun, sir?
Well, before we started this press call, I was in touch with Commissioner Goyente of Bureau of Immigration. And also yesterday, I have been in touch with the DNA USEC July. And as we are having this conference now, as we are speaking, the DI is already implementing the presidential directive. Okay, so mga dyan, nalagay magpapaskel na ng mga notices ala Singapore that also imposed a China-wide temporary ban. So we're doing the same. And the DNA is sending notice to the nations in China, the Philippine nations in China.
Sir, siguro napakahalaga yung information niya kasi nagkakagulo nga po, sir, yung mga dissemination information, yung mga also bilang. Pwede bang na-i-stress natin sa masa na yung authority, yung kapangyarihan, eh, dapat galing talaga sa inyo para may mga information kung saan saan mga nanggagaling na nakakalito at alarming sa taong bayan sa.
Right, gaya ng sinabi ko, yung mag-uumpisa niya dun sa presidential directive. Okay, na kanina umaga, una na lang sinabi ni Senator Bongo at ngayon naman si Sec. Salcanelo ang nagbigay ng directive para sa mga ahensya na ipatupad itong hangarin ni Pangulo na para sa kapakanan at proteksyon ng ating mga kababayan ay dapat kaagaran ipatupad. At pinapatupad na habang andito tayo sa PressCon ay kumikilos na ang ating DOJ, Bureau of Immigration at saka DHA.
Sir, speaking of kumikilos, ibig sabihin may sapat pa,
lastly? Next question po tayo sa Director General. Please, next question.
Sir, ilan na po yung PUI studied in total? And kamusta po yung condition ng first kids?
So meron po tayong 36 na PUI. It will probably be updated sa Monday and Tuesday. Of the 36 cases natin, yung dalawa yung positive, so 34. Dito sa RITF, 24 were found to be negative. Sa Australia, meron tayong 6 na negative. Una yung bata, and then second yung batch na 5, no? Kasama naman yung positive. So that brings it to 30. Meron tayong 4 ngayon na under testing pa sa RITF, but all of the patients are stable and doing well. Okay, one last question.
Yung first discharge,
how can we assure that also our health workers are protected against this
terrible
virus?
Dr. Solano, often that's what I think for children. So like most of the referral hospitals, we strictly implement full PPE. And full personal protective equipment for those who are handling suspect and confirmed cases of personal under investigation. No.
Sir, how about po yung mga visitors
and mga patients? So for the visitors in hospitals, they're not required to wear any mask unless any personnel in the high-risk area should wear all those protective equipment. But for the visitors, we discourage them wearing those masks, but unless they have respiratory symptoms that they want to be protected, or they want to protect themselves, and I think that's the usual procedure to do. But for any individual in the hospital, outside of the hospital, it's still hand hygiene and cough etiquette that is very important. Yeah, for those patients under in the PUI that are currently admitted in the hospitals, we don't allow any visitors. Yes, we are in a highly restricted, designated area. Now in the high risk area, I think we have 4, where the 2 patients were admitted. We have 4 admitted patients in that high risk area.
One last question. Wala na, maraming salamat po.
We continue to identify H1N1 because they are now community acquired. Never started the outbreak in 2009. And subsequently, this became a community acquired pathogen. So it's sort of something normal which we see in our influenza surveillance.
But I would like to add that Having said that, that is why it is important to do hand washing and cough etiquette, because you have many viruses here, okay, and elsewhere. You have the AH1N1 influenza, the seasonal flu. You have influenza type A, influenza type B for the viruses, and then you have the bacteria infection caused by your Klebsiella pneumoniae, the Staphylococcus pneumoniae, and also the Haemophilus influenza. So that's why this study hindi lang po ito usapin patungkol sa N coronavirus. Marami talaga tayo ng infection. So, mag-iing natin tayo kapag pagsama ng ating resistensya, magpalakas tayo ng ating mga kakawan dahil lalo na po mga matatanda, hindi po pong bigyan-biin na talagang sila ang ating bibigyan prioridad sa mga pangangalaga na kinakailangan. So, we prioritize the elderly with those co-existing or underlying medical problems. Many of the cases in China have been observed, or rather the deaths, the first 40, most of these will be with underlying medical problems. Okay? So, meron sa atin, dapat mag-iing na tayo, lalo na po ang mga matatanda, yung chronic conditions.
Sir,
sa case
number 2 po,
ay nahawak
po ba kay
case
number 1?
Ang malina lang, they are partners.
Mas malina po yung immune
system nito pangalawa? The end po talaga wide range from mild to severe. Hindi pa rin natin matang.
That is the information lang. Sorry. I think it's important to include as pasensya na, no? Kasi halos wala ka kanito. We should mention that in these patients, no? Meron din silang mixed pathogens, no? Mixed infection, I would say, due to influenza B and Streptococcus pneumoniae. So, meron na halo-halo na mga pathogens o mga sanhi ng kanyang ipinakita ng pneumonia. Okay?
Thank you very much, everybody. Please enjoy the rest of Sunday.